especially because they are trusted medical doctors who are creating disease, it's very important that all the money that is going into trying to find the causes of disease actually go into the court trying to find the causes of disease. And one of the points that we very briefly mentioned earlier was the question of why cancer is increasing in society. Now, we've known since, from the fact that in fact Marie and Pierre Curie died of cancer with working with radioactivity, that in fact radioactivity causes cancer. Now, I've got a book that was published in 1959 by a thing called Frontiers of Science. It was an Allen and Unwin, or Unwin publication. And it had this guy called Sturtevant, who was a professor of nuclear medicine. Not nuclear medicine, of nuclear physics. And he pointed out that there is no safe amount of radiation when you're talking about nuclear fallout. Now, at the time, what he's saying is it's a cumulative risk. So every generation will have added to it the risk of the previous generations because of the long half-life and the decay life of the nuclear radiation. Now, if you think about the total number of atom bombs that have been exploded under the ground, on the ground, and in the air over the last 50 years, that is one very, very obvious reason as to why there would be an increase in cancer generally.
But what about the link to stress that we've been talking about and the fact that society is getting faster and faster, and that's also another ramification is cancer?
Absolutely, absolutely. This is goes back to the a problem that was created in part by a huge adherence to a Greek father of medicine by the name of Galen. And Galen said that every disease is caused by one single point, cause, and there is a single cure. And in fact, he was the one who had the cure. Now, Galen was, by all accounts, a very arrogant man. And but Galen's doctrine was virtually unchallenged for hundreds of years, 1,500 years, something like that. And now, slowly, people are adopting a holistic approach where they're looking at all the different factors that cause something like cancer. Obviously, we know that one thing doesn't cause cancer, but we know that a lot of different things cause different types of cancer. It's a very complex area. My complaint and my concern is that the research that is being done and all the money that is public money that is being spent from the NHMRC plus the cancer research charities of various sorts are going in to develop new drugs. It's all to do with develop new drugs with a promise that they may develop a vaccine at some stage. It's not
for cancer and for everything.
A vaccine for cancer and for everything else. And at the same time, the serious health problems, and I'm talking about chronic health problems from vaccines, are not being admitted.
The ramifications of taking these vaccines and stuff, you mean?
Yeah, exactly. The long-term problems that, for example, I found out when I was looking at one of the annual reports of one of the research organizations, and I can't remember exactly which one it was, saying that they were trying to develop a new rubella and measles rubella vaccine that didn't cause an increase in arthritis. Now, most people have no idea that rubella vaccines increase arthritis. And they're not telling people about problems like that. Unless you develop anaphylactic shock and drop down dead on the spot, it's very hard for them to convince an establishment that doesn't want to be convinced about the risks of vaccines. And that leads me to the issue of AIDS, I suppose, because I have recently been in communication with Alan Cantwell, who's a dermatologist in the United States, who has written two books on his theoretical work that and his research work that AIDS was caused by infected vaccines. That AIDS was introduced, or the HIV virus was introduced intentionally through infected vaccines.
Deliberately so.
Deliberately.
To create a disease.
To create a disease.
To broaden the drug market.
Broaden the drug market is one plausible reason, but there are many others which have been fulfilled by the AIDS epidemic as the AIDS epidemic has developed over the last 20 years. Now, the reason that I started looking at AIDS was because of my research into eugenics. And eugenics, I became interested in, as I said, because of my interest in psychiatry. And I found that the eugenics theories were basically racist theories. They were white supremacist theories in their most obvious form. But white supremacist theories that were developed by the English. So they were Anglo supremacist theories in their original form. Now, the person who developed the word eugenics, or the concept of eugenics, was Charles Darwin's first cousin, whose name was Francis Galton. And Francis Galton wrote a very influential book in 1869 called Hereditary Genius, in which he argued that families such as his own contain hereditary genius. And that is why there are so many prominent